Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
My name is Stephen Cabral. I'm an AKC registered handler for about 10 years, and I've been actively involved in Beagle showing for probably about 12 years now in confirmation dog shows. Beagle is a great pet. It's such a family dog. Gets along with pretty much any breed of dog, but it's got a lot of energy. A fun dog, comical dog, but somewhat mischievous as well. The Beagle is just pure comedy. It is a dog that is somewhat like a cat, will do its own thing. If you're there, if you're not, it really doesn't care. But when it's ready, it will cuddle with you. It will join the family. It will have a lot of fun. But it likes to get into things, and it likes to be a little bit of trouble, like having a 2 or 3 year old. Running around the house. The Beagle can tend to get into a lot of trouble because it uses its nose a lot. If you let it out, it's down onto the ground, it's smelling things, it's looking for whatever it wants to look for, but it, because of its keen sense of smell, it will go through in and out through bushes, in and out through rocks, just hunting, looking, and trying to find things. And as its nose goes down and smells, its tail comes up. And that's one of the key characteristics of the breed. It helps find them in tall brush, because you're seeing that tail wiggling up there, and the white little tip is like a little beacon, but they will sniff and smell things out. But they are comical dogs. They're pack dogs, whether with other beagles or an entire family, they consider them their pack. Characteristics of a Beagle is it's a nice compact dog. They come in two sizes and varieties. They have up to 15 inch is one, and up to 13 inch is the other one. They should have a very houndy look, long leathery ears with a nice soft expression on them. White tail, tip of the tail is very, very strong characteristic of the breed. And it should almost be like a foxhound in a smaller version. The Beagle belongs in the hound group, and it's a series of hounds for actually working purposes, and there's different varieties of hounds. You have your sight hounds that utilize vision for tracking and finding prey, and then you also have the scent hounds, which is what the Beagles fall under, and they utilize their nose in order to track prey for their owners. The sight hounds themselves use more of visualization, so it's a faster dog. They spot their prey and then move quickly. The Beagles are scent, so they tend to sniff ground, track them by slow process, and then eventually get to their prey. And then they will actually bark, and it's a baroo. It's not so much a bark, to send a signal to the owners that they have tracked what they are looking for. And it's like a beacon. So they're constant baroo, 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 and then you will key in on that, and they'll hold the prey into that area, which is when you'll actually capture it. The Beagle was created in essence for fox hunting, small vermin hunting, and they would do it in packs. So the hunters would be on horseback and send out the pack of Beagles for that scent. They would track the vermin down or the fox by smelling, and as the fox would continue to keep running, they would follow the scent, similar to like the bloodhound. Breed standard for a Beagle is, in the first size, is a Beagle up to 13 inch in size, roughly about 25, no more than 30 pounds. The second variety of Beagle is a Beagle over 13 inches, but under 15 inches, with a soft expression, long leathery ears. Aside from hunting and what they've done in the past, today you'll commonly find Beagles at airports and ports of call. They make wonderful drug sniffing, bomb sniffing dogs, so they're constantly working in that respect. The correct temperament for the Beagle is, as they say in the breed standard, it's the merry little hound or the merry little dog. So they should be a very joyful dog, non-aggressive, overly friendly dog, when they want to be. It's everything is on their terms. And just a lot of fun as a dog. And as far as you know, their functions with the family and everything else, they make great companions with the family. Socialization for this breed is very important, like with any breed. The more you socialize them, the better they're going to be when going into public and interacting with the public and with other dogs. But this breed is also very non-threatening, so they tend to interact with dogs very, very well. Obedience training it can be a challenging because a Beagle will do what a Beagle wants to do. So if it decides it doesn't want to be trained, it won't do it. But Beagles are trainable. It just requires a little special effort and extra training in order to get them to do what you want them to do. They are an intelligent breed. They express themselves, and in essence, they'll do what they want to do, and they'll figure things out on their own. They are a mischievous breed, and anybody that's ever had a kid or 2-year-old is basically had a Beagle. And so they're challenging, they get into things, and you look at them and shake your head and go, how in the heck did you get into there? How in the heck did you do that? But that's pretty much the essence of a Beagle. The life expectancy of a Beagle is roughly about 12 years of age. Well, like most breeds, cancer is a common problem within Beagles, and a lot of breeds they've had that. Epilepsy is also seen inside the breed, but for the most part, after that, they're generally a fairly healthy breed. Beagles are clean when they want to be clean. You can bathe the dog, and if you turn them loose, they will get themselves dirty. Again, it's that mischievous attitude that they have. It's probably better to throw dirt on them because then they'll go out and clean themselves. But as far as grooming, they really don't require much grooming. They will grow hair around the necks and that needs to be clipped, but for the most part, a good brushing, a good bath, and you're good to go with a Beagle. The best way to maintain their weights is just monitoring the amount of food that they eat. Beagles currently right now, we feed about maybe a little over a cup a day of food, a cup and a quarter of a day, but one or two kibbles can make a huge difference on a Beagle. Get that in there and they'll balloon right up. Reduce it a little bit, they'll go super skinny. So you'll commonly see, if you walk on the street anywhere, super fat Beagles, because they will eat. And the more you give them, the more they will eat. Beagles are very social animals, and they're very much an outdoor dog. I mean, you can have them out, they want to explore. They want to find new things. But Beagles do love to be inside the house. When they're done, they like to curl up on the couch with you, watch TV, or just sit there with you, even lay by on your feet on the floor. They're very, very social. They love contact with groups of people. The first Beagle that we saw today was Finn. He's a 4-year-old Beagle that my fiance bred. He's a red and white Beagle, roughly just under 15 inches, so he's in the 15-inch Beagle category. And it's challenging because most people consider Beagles to have black saddles. He's a red and white, which is commonly seen in the hunting in back east. His accomplishments, he's competed at Westminster. He's been a top 20 dog in the country of all Beagles and competed at the national specialty. He's competed at local shows, but now he's being currently shown by his owner, Lou, in the owner handler category, which is a category AKC created for owners to be actively involved in showing their own dogs, unlike hiring a professional handler like myself. And currently I think Lou and Finn are probably in the top 5 in the country for owner-handler Beagles. The second Beagle that we saw was a black tri, and that's Yardley, female, and she's roughly about 2 years of age. And we got her from a great breeder in Northern California, and her accomplishments is she's a multi-specialty winner, winning the big Denver specialty. She's just starting her career. right now, and we're hoping that she makes the top 20 this year in competition. But she is the bride-to-be of Finn, probably by next year. You know, with Finn, you know, it's been an absolute joy. I've specialed him for the last 2 years, and you know, making the top 20 was a major accomplishment and joy for me as a handler and relatively new into Beagles. We're getting ready to head off to New York for his swan song to show, as well as Yardley. Yardley will be her first attempt at Westminster competition. And the future for me for Beagles is probably going to be good, since my fiance has Beagles, I'm marrying into Beagles, and since the two will be bred, I see a bunch of little Beagles running around and having me chase them for years to come.